I'm I'm Mayor and Council, you know, my name's Tom Smith. We've got 10 minutes to start in the presentation. Take 7 minutes to begin with, and we deserve hopefully 3 minutes for a follow-up. I don't have a whole lot to say, but I do have some documents to put into, I'll hand you all copies. You know, I have a, one is a little more. We have Exhibit 1, which is a letter that I sent to Ms. Corcoran on September 1. Exhibit 2 is a memorandum that's in front of you, that has some videos attached to it that I'm going to summarize. And then Exhibit Number 3 is an affidavit from Ms. Chang that I am also going to summarize, if you can read them for yourself. What essentially prompted this particular letter and this particular meeting was, I had a conversation with the sheriff of Barrow County, which you all know is the chief law enforcement officer of Barrow County. And he had an encounter with Ms. Corcoran, and they have conducted a number of investigations in the town. And she's called complaining about our employees. And Sheriff Smith reported to me that our employees, city's employees, have told him that they feel like this is a hostile environment created by Ms. Corcoran. And so those conversations are summarized. An encounter that she had with the sheriff is on a video, on a disc, is Exhibit A to Exhibit 2. And the mayor's version, which is going to the minutes of the council meeting, has those discs. Another incident, there is attached to the minutes, Exhibit B, is an email string between Ms. Corcoran and Ms. Heather Carver. Ms. Carver is the secretary to Superior, Barrow County Superior Court Judge, Curry Minglethorpe, in front of whom the open records cases that Ms. Corcoran has filed against the city were pending. My partner, Angela Couch, represents the city, and she's reported to me that Ms. Corcoran has been professional and courteous when dealing with court and the officials, until what's reflected in this email, whereupon she accused the secretary of collusion, of inappropriate, of abuse of power, and of withholding information. And that, in conjunction with that kind of escalation of her treatment of court officials, the comment from the chief law enforcement officer of Barrow County, and then the affidavit from Ms. Chang, where she reports about Ms. Corcoran's treatment of her, and especially her treatment of one of our assistant clerks, Sandra Bennett, on August 8th, because of the encounter between Ms. Bennett and Ms. Corcoran, Ms. Bennett reported that she felt like that had created a hostile work environment. Ms. Corcoran actually reported that Ms. Bennett had assaulted her, short of the police took out an incident report. That is also attached to the memo. And in the videos is the video of the city security camera, which shows that there was no contact between Ms. Corcoran and Ms. Bennett. And then the final thing that's attached to the memo are three articles that deal with workplace violence. And there was one in the third one of those, Exhibit F3, there's a paragraph that I set out specifically in on page 3 of the memo. And it says, in the second type 2, the assailant has a legitimate relationship with the organization, commits an act of violence while being served by the organization. And although the perpetrators of type 2 aggression rarely kill their victims, they are responsible for an estimated 60% of all non-fatal assaults at work. Employees who provide service, care, advice, or education, for example, nurses, social workers, and teachers, are at increased risk of type 2 aggression, especially if their clients, customers, or patients are experiencing frustration, insecurity, or stress, not suggesting Ms. Corcoran has committed any criminal acts. However, in light of the escalation of conduct that we've seen with court officials, in light of the fact that the chief law enforcement officer of Barrow County reported to me that the employees of the city had reported to his investigators, that they felt like this was a hostile work environment due to the citizen. In light of what we know, what these articles say, it was appropriate to bring this matter to your attention, for you all to do whatever you deem appropriate. department to the parks, and then the various sewer and water easements that are not in right of way. She's clearly entitled to be on roads and stadium. The city are authorized to include the code of the city, and the owner of the property has to be fit along the Heather Brook, and then to be used to say she can't come into the property after the brook.
I have one follow-up comment, actually. Again, referring to Mr. Mitchell's problem with honesty. Mike Channing has not had to redact, I don't believe, a single thing that she has sent to me. The only things that have been redacted were police reports. Those were sent by Tracy Pollard, and they have a system, the computer system, that auto-redacts them. So in other words, they're not printing them out and then redacting them with a pencil. It's done automatically through the computer system. So she has never had to do that. As far as payment, I pay in person, in cash. As many of you know, I've probably paid a good deal over $6,000 at this point in open records. So payment has not ever been a problem. And again, I would encourage you to do your homework. This is a very serious matter, given the fact that Mr. Mitchell is about to subject you to further litigation. So please consider not just what he says. I would say you should do a regular investigation.
Number of the records that the court are personnel files or files that have information included in the main release or by the open records act. Those do have to be copied in the act. That's the report.
I would encourage you to ask for the records that Ms. Chang has redacted. Just ask to see how many that she personally redacted. You don't have to take my word for it. Ask to see the records that she redacted. It'll be less than a handful.
I make a motion that Ms. Corcoran prevented from entering any of our city buildings, parks, and any easements that we have other than those that require her to be able to go on roads and such. As far as open records, I make a motion that we do the procedures as recommended by Thomas Mitchell.
There was two motions.
Actually, was that the motion?
I would make that.
There should be one motion then another one.
I just want to make it clear the city will still have to comply with the open records act, and we'll make sure that the staff will make sure that the open records act is complied with. We had the attorney general found that we have.
Then I make that first motion.
Okay, do we have a second?
Yes, sir.
All in favor?
Thank you.
Member McCormick, do you want to vote?
He did.
He said aye.
I'm grateful for your decision.
We did the second motion.
We don't need the second motion.
Okay.
All in favor? We never done that.
We don't.
Executive session.
We don't have a session. Can we proceed now with our general?
We need to adjourn the special call meeting.
Okay. At this time, returning from the meeting.
You want to
motion with her. Okay, I'll second.
All in favor?
No.
So now they want to legally violate the oath and read that.
Why are we going to stay on? Okay, I just want to make sure I didn't get wrong about it. Okay. Five names.
Okay.
Okay.
You're out, just curious.
I understand.
I
use the third and 94th, we need a longer meeting to be on the.
Okay, we're coming to all of my workshops, so it's in the first thing to be about, maybe.
We're gonna begin with the proposed 2018 millage rate. Our proposed 2018 millage rate is gonna be at the 4.355. And we do need to vote on next Tuesday.
Vote on next Tuesday?
Yes.
Any questions?
No.
Second reading of amendment to open records officer ordinance.
Any questions about this?
Anybody else supporting?
Moving on to the next item, second reading of the rezoning at 342 Price Street from R1 to R2. That was provided to you last night as well. Any questions on that? Eddie's barbecue update.
They are here.
Hey, you want to tell them?
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
So I called my family for some backup because I see a lot of angry folks up here. So I want to introduce somebody here. I'll start with my big brother, Antonio Nelson, and my big cousin, Pit Master, Dino Boy, and my lovely mom, Shirley Nelson, and everything. So y'all can't do me too bad today because my family's watching. I'm glad all the police are left off to the back.
Not angry, just concerned.
So I'm glad you guys voted us in and wanted us to be here. We want to be here, and we're excited about it, but we all know it takes a little paperwork to get things done. We had to go ahead back in, I want to say, April with the health department and everything. And we had the floor plans all submitted and everything, and told us to go ahead, and the fire marshal happened to come out and said we need to add a door. And when you add on to the floor plans and everything, permits that gave us to go ahead with the health department got canceled. So with that being said, I had to go back to the drawing board and took a little extra time, get some more floor plans put together, speak with the health department, just a slow process. So now we have a final blueprint. But what it is, this is the actual, what they actually submitted, which was here. So just the original door here, and the fire marshal said the second door there, which is going to have the grill, the spirit wall, the alley, like that. So just that, moving that briefly to space, the health department had basically shut it down, but then she gave us the guidance of bringing in a walk-in cooler and everything, which would give us more than enough room to store food and actually prepare. Build-out time should be shortest anywhere from 14 to 60 days, if 60 days being the max. But it's only 325 square feet, and I've got a whole crew that I'll hop that on. And, so
are you saying you're going to be right now?
Yes, sir. we wait for Michelle Huff down at the Barrow County Health Department. She has everything submitted. She's saying that we'll have an answer. Probably no way tomorrow, so I can get Ms. Maya call or Ms. Michelle call and just give them an update on that. We're ready to go, and hopefully I can have you out here next week. That's one. But
fire marshal already walked the building with me, so he threw the wrench, the monkey wrench there, but with him there and everything, and with the extra door added, it looked like it was going to be full steam ahead of here shortly. I did bring some samples. With some cakes in there.
I see you put in the fryer for the four burner cook with the range, with the exhaust hood. Is that how we're going to handle the hood coming up the roof, or how's that going?
Speaking of my GC and everything, we're going to run a 6-foot hood, and it looks like the structure is so, well enough to support it. I'm meeting with the third party, Mr. Hale, the permit.
Alchip.
Okay. So I'm meeting with him. I think I got that on the calendar for Monday. So we're going to go over everything just to make sure everything's good. But my GC, you've been out here at least four times now.
Okay, that's all.
Yes, the van will be up. Yes.
Okay, I'm just asking just a question. So how are we going to be working?
We together,
I have no problem. I have no question. Since we're turning over to our inspectors and all.
Oh, I'm glad you said that. So we did, so we called Miss Betty and everything, and spoke about the festival on Saturday. So I think we will be out here. My family's ready to go. Got the thumbs up? All right. Take it with that. But yeah, we're going to actually put, and I wanted to see if it was okay. Is it in there? Yes, sir. So we're giving the banner. And we were looking to put this up and fly it on Saturday, so the city will know that the shack is coming. And I think it'll be a nice concept for the city. And we'll be able to get our taste out and see how everybody enjoying it and move forward from there. All right. All right. Thank you, guys. And don't forget, we're going to put on the samples in the back.
Right.
Get your
other
right.
Thank you.
Thanks for that. Okay. Next is GNX Health Insurance Open Enrollment.
We received the increase of GNX on the health insurance. And you should have a copy of the paper that I sent, and you guys copy of I put the amount of increases for each payer, employee, family, employee, house only, and employee and children only. So, and October is open enrollment month, so if anybody wants to make any changes, then they can do it after that time.
Okay, how long do they have?
The whole month of October.
The whole month.
For changes.
This needs to be voted on on the vote order or just
relative information? No, it's just information, okay. Yes. But, last year we tried to get some quotes in, and we were told that GMA provides the lowest rate for the city of our size.
Next on the agenda is meeting procedures.
The Maryland County Board of Commissioners has a fairly lengthy set of rules and procedures, and Mr. Barton had invited me to review to talk to you all about. I've looked over them. I mean, there's nothing wrong with them. It's a whole lot more formal than you all are used to operating. I know that some of you attended Maryland County Board of Commissioners meetings with Chris Brown, the chairman of the GMA group over there. And so it is more formal. This is the procedures they have adopted, they call out that they abide by Robert's Rule of Order newly revised. The city also, the problem here is that we follow Robert's Rule to the extent that we ever need to rely on those. But there's a number of provisions in here about how motions are made, how meetings are adjourned, what that means, and how motions are made, the arranging of motions, and all that kind of thing. It's entirely appropriate to do. There are the GMA also has a white paper. If you go to the GMA website, if you go into resources, there, I think it's, the, you know, it's somewhere in the top, the first 10 that you'll see. Is a document on parliamentary procedures in council meetings, and they've got some forms in there as well. I'm happy to put something together for you all, which is going to depend on how formal you all want to be.
My personal desires is to have sensible meetings, you know, reasonably controlled. Did Thomas get a copy of this? If you look at item 5, the public comment on agenda items, these actually come, you know, the instructions from it comes from that plan or procedure. And, you know, but this is the only part that I want out of it. So, if you could, and I don't know if we can do it for Tuesday,
sure.
But if we could just modify our current legal procedures, you know, in our ordinances to these specifications, and just so that everybody knows, it's limit 2 minutes per person on agenda items only. Those are the ones that are set by the city, which are not scheduled to have public hearing. So that's it. And the one other thing in there that we would want was a limit of 10 minutes total for all public comment. If you could do that for us, that would curtail some of the.
Do you want that in the form of an ordinance, or do you all want it as a procedure?
Can we do it as a procedure?
You do it as a procedure. It is a matter.
Does it contradict?
Yes, does it override the ordinance we already have?
I'll check the ordinance and see what the ordinance actually says. Mm-hmm. If it needs to be required, then I'll have that as well.
That would be great. So that we can, you know, so that we can go ahead. If we have to do amendments,
my first day down.
Or Tuesday.
And that's not uncommon. I came to the Oconee County Board of Commissioners meeting a couple times the last couple months. They do the same thing. They only take public comment on the agenda items.
And if a citizen wants to discuss something or something to come onto the agenda, they can speak to the city government and ask the city to discuss it.
And there's always correspondence. The citizen that has this concern can always submit correspondence and that can be attached to the minutes. And that's another appropriate way to communicate to the county.
If we could. Thank you, John.
Any other comments? Questions? Next item is the Christmas Festival. I know we began discussion on that last month.
Well, the sunflower turned out to be the biggest ever. And after filling it in 178 spots, I don't even want to talk about it. But I have spoke to Deborah and to Terry. I will not be in charge. I will help anybody that wants to take the Christmas over. I'll do all I can to help them, but until I get some health issues dealt with, I will not take on the responsibility. So if you two ladies back there want to kind of fill one in on what I talked about.
No, we were just talking about things, something real simple. Do I need to go to the podium or does
That's okay.
Yeah.
You'll be all right.
Okay, all right. Hi. We were discussing a tentative date of maybe Friday, December 7th, 5 to 8 p.m. Just tentatively, this could change. And just doing maybe some s'mores and some hot chocolate, doing tree lighting in the gazebo, and maybe have some caroling by the local church and children. Well, that was really the extent of it. Yes, possibly, and then also seeing if some of the businesses wanted to stay open later as well. So it's still very, you know, up in the air, but that's kind of what we discussed so far. Unless you'd like to see something a little bit more extravagant, then I'm not going to sign you up on something. But and does that sound appropriate?
Yeah, I think what we decided is not be the festival, like bringing in vendors and everything, that it would be Christmas.
Yes, and just the community. And then we discussed too, food drive, toy drive, we're going to all talk to kind of see how we can maybe incorporate that, get that back into the community too. So further discussions needed. We're going to let the study get over some of our festival first. Okay. Thank you.
Find some of the younger people stuff, right?
So we can.
Yeah. It's not easy.
I love doing it, but this is the hardest one to get. Because I had to tell Mike to get the push thing and it's together, so.
And it's bigger than us.
Right. 178 spots. I ran out of spots and electricity. Yeah. What would they do? We just kept moving here and there. We gotta know if the other side.
Okay, do we need to go on the table, sir?
We need to.
Okay. We have a motion to adjourn.
I'm going to go to the next one.